This is known as spiderwort.
This is a fabulous edible right here. This is actually one of my favorites.
Wort is an old English word for weed.
This is a fabulous edible right here. This is actually one of my favorites. This is known as spiderwort.
Wort is an old English word for weed, and this is just really delicious. Last year up in Wyoming, I harvested a few of these plants and cooked them up, and I'm going to do a video about that this year. In fact, we'll probably do that today.
In the leaf stage, spiderwort can loosely resemble death camas, and so there's a couple ways you can distinguish it.
One of the things is just the way the leaves come off the stalk is very different than death camas. I'll share with you another couple characteristics that are unique to spiderwort as compared to death camas. It's good to have several identifying characteristics with any plant. So I'm going to pull a leaf off here. So one of the things about spiderwort is that when you pull the leaf apart, there's like some sticky sap. No, it's not sap, but it's a sticky substance. And if you reconnect the leaf where you pulled it apart, and then pull it like that, you'll see it's kind of like a spider web. At all stages of growth, except as the plant is dying, you'll notice this. And this is one of the ways you can determine whether you have death camas or spiderwort. So you just look for this characteristic. This is a delicious edible. The leaves can be enjoyed raw.
But it has a little bit of a hint of a bitter taste to it. I really like the taste, but it's just a little bit of a hint of a bitter taste. You can also eat these beautiful blooms. This is another way to identify spiderwort, is these purple blooms. These are very brief blooming period for each one of these, but you'll see the buds here of other blooms. So I believe that this one will be shriveled up and gone by the end of today, but these other buds will bloom out over the next couple days, maybe week. There's a lot more buds right in here. This entire plant can be enjoyed raw or cooked. My favorite way to enjoy this is actually to cook it. Like last year, I made a little vegetable soup out of some wild edibles that I had collected, spiderwort being one of them. So I'm going to actually go ahead and dig up this plant here. Sometimes the spiderwort gets quite a bit bigger than this one. This is a pretty decent size. This is another way to distinguish spiderwort from death camas. Death camas has a bulb that's onion-like because it is in the lily family, whereas spiderwort has a very different type of root. So I guess not all lily family members have a bulb, but death camas and them do. So just a distinguishing characteristic. This is some pretty rocky soil here. So it's not coming out quite as freely as it usually does. So this is what the roots of the spiderwort look like. Now, what I'm going to do a little bit later today, along with some of the other edibles that I've collected, I'm going to cook this up in a pot of water. And I'm going to use this part of the root, and I'm going to include some of the leaves, and just let it simmer in the pot of water for a while, along with some of the other edibles. I found this to be really, really tasty, along with the leaves and the flower buds and the actual flower blooms as well. So I'm really excited about trying this out. You'll notice that with this spiderwort bloom, you'll see that it has three petals with three sepals surrounding it. These areas right here, these green things that look almost like petals. And you'll also notice that the stamens in there have like yellow pollen on them. This is not a prime bloom right here. It's been sitting in the direct sunlight for a number of hours, and it's kind of shriveled up a little bit, but it still looks very beautiful. This is definitely one of my favorite plants, wild edibles. One other thing I actually wanted to point out here, you'll notice that the leaves of spiderwort clasp the stem. You'll notice all along these leaves just clasp the stem, the main flower stem. So that's another identifying characteristic of spiderwort. Check out my next video where I will be cooking up some of these delicious edibles that I have harvested today.